Hey guys, welcome back. Today I'm literally right in the middle of El Centro. We're just walking around, and I think we're just gonna do some walking and talking because I'm in the middle of El Centro and I really gotta like cut through the middle even further, and I gotta just, you know, make my way north. So I figured, you know what, let me just turn the camera on and show you guys from my perspective. So in this video, I'm gonna be flipping the camera around for the good majority of the video, and I'll be showing you guys what I'm seeing from my perspective. And maybe, you know, I'm gonna see if I can do some, you know, added commentary, but we'll play it by ear. So, all right, without further ado, I'll give you my point of view. All right, guys, let's enjoy together. So yeah, you know, we're just doing this from my perspective, so that I can show you guys, you know, what it really looks like out here. So today is Thursday at noon. Right now it's Thursday noon, literally, all right? 12 o'clock noon, lunchtime. It's also very, very, very hot. And Mexican Independence Day is right around the corner. That's where you're gonna be seeing all kinds of, you know, Mexican Independence Day, which, by the way, it's September 15th, all right? September 15th is Mexican Independence Day. Not Cinco de Mayo, all right? You fuckers. You fucking fuckers out there. I usually have the camera pointed at myself, and it makes recording a lot easier. It's actually a lot harder to record when you're pointing the camera at other people because it's like pointing a gun at people. All right, I'm gonna stop turning the camera around. I'm gonna see if I can just talk to you guys like this. Hopefully the sound comes out. Hopefully you guys can hear what I'm saying because it's very difficult. Let's see, look at this guy. So usually, you know, this is, I walk around this all the time, but I'm always pointing the camera at myself. So it's like, it's harder for you guys to see things. Mexican stuff. Oh, we got the military out here. Hell yeah. Not hell yeah. No bueno, but whatever. What are we gonna do? Oh, they're doing some stuff there. Look at that. Some military stuff. What was that? Let's check this out. All right, hold on. Ah, they're recruiting for the Mexican army. Oh, interesting. There's a little recruiting for the Mexican army. Interesting. Look at this part. By the way, it's usually more full with more vendors and all kinds of shit. It's pretty empty today. I'm guessing it's because of school starting. Look at this, man. Look at that. Mexico, baby. I used to live more that way. further out that way. We're gonna, you know what? Let's walk a little further that way. Why not? Out there, okay, so that's the market, all right? We don't gotta go there. I got like a lot of things to do, but that's like all the way at the end of that street. It's a dead end. It's about half a block. That's like the market. Cool, right? All right, so we're just gonna walk through here. By the way, I'm walking in the direct heat to get the best possible lighting for you guys, all right? You're welcome, all right? Look at this, liquor store. Look at this guy. Look at this, like this is like my head hits this. You see, look how short. I got like. We got Usher playing back there. Yeah, man. See, it's funny because like every single one of these places is playing a different kind of music. You got Usher back there. We got salsa, merengue. We got all kinds of shit playing everywhere. And we're just going deeper and deeper into the heart of the city here. Look at this hat store. Piñatas, you already know it. I want one of these for my birthday, damn it. I'm gonna ask my girlfriend to get me a fucking piñata. Let me see how much that is. Don't eat the pizza here. Not just here, anywhere. Pizza no bueno out here. Especially if you come from, look at that music. Yeah, man. So look, see, check this out. It's like a main intersection out here. This is 65, all right? This is 54, I think. Yeah, 54 goes that way, I think. And that's like a main, it's like a main artery here. So out here in this corner, they sell really good tacos and really good stuff. And look at this. Look, it's like meat markets and banks and all kinds of shit out that way. Again, I don't have to go that way. We're not going that direction, but out there. And as you guys can see, look, so like, there's a lot of traffic that way. And we got this guy leading helping with the traffic. I'm gonna see if I can show you guys a little bit so you guys can see what's up. But see, look at all that heavy traffic. I'm not quite sure if you guys can see it or not. All right, I gotta go north here. All right, I gotta go this way. All right, so we're gonna go that way. All right. Haven't I seen that guy already going in circles? I think it's like the third time we see that guy with the green shit. But look, see, look, it's more selling of stuff. Look how old these buildings are. Look at the history, man. Cool. All right. More music. Yeah, whenever you guys see me dancing, it's just because there's music in the background, and I'll probably put some other music behind that. But, you know, I'm sure you guys already figured it out by now. So yeah, I mean, you know, it's a lot harder to talk when the camera's not being pointed at myself. When I got the camera pointing at me, I can't shut the fuck up. But when I'm not pointing the camera at me, it's a lot harder to talk because I'm literally talking to myself for reals. There's no camera or anything like that. And I think we're going the right way. I'm hoping I'm going the right way. I think, I got a feeling I'm going the right way. So you see the streets right there, 63 and 54. I'm pretty sure I gotta be on 54. Can I cross? All right, yeah. I gotta be on 54 and like 53. So I got like 10 more blocks, which is 5 more blocks. It's really 5 more blocks, but I gotta go 5 more blocks going north. But that's it. As you guys can see, the action's already dying down because we're leaving the center and now we're going north. All right. But I'm gonna see. I'm gonna keep pointing it towards the front so you guys can get, again, more of a perspective of the perspective I get. All right. We got a pawn shop here. A lot of music playing, but anyway, that was the pawn shop there. They buy silver, buy gold, sell silver, sell gold. So yeah, the place I gotta go to is on 54th, and I literally picked the street that was, you know, so that I can also walk down to show you guys as much as possible. But I got a feeling there's more shit going down on that street, on those streets, because I usually walk down those. It's actually pretty dead. But I think it's also because school just started and, you know, the streets are just emptier. This is every single city, man, you know? We gotta remember, when school starts, it's not just for little kids. It's for people going to university, for people everywhere. And this goes for every single city that you're at. Oh yeah, I used to walk down this street, as a matter of fact. And you can probably not see it there, but that arch all the way at the end of the street, that arch at the end of the street has like a little opening on each side of the street. I'm not gonna walk all the way down there, but the archway is like down here. It's like 3 foot tall. It's like a 3 foot tall archway, but I'm not quite sure when they built that. You know what I mean? If they built that, if they built that back in the day, you know, when the people were, they were living here, were smaller, or if they built it afterwards, you know, kind of like a whatchamacallit, like artistic thing or a cultural thing. Anyways, whatever. I'm sure if you look at my really old videos from over a year ago, when I walked around here and stuff like that, around these areas, because I used to live closer to, you know, these areas out here, and I know I talked about that, and I've gone through one of those, but I gotta make my way out there anyways. But yeah, so you know Merida is a very, very interesting place. You know, a lot of these places, you know, they might seem like they're closed, but they're not. They're open, you know, everything's open. Every one of these places are businesses. This actually seems to be abandoned, one of the few abandoned things out here, which is very rare. For the most part, you know, there's tubs, you know, these things are all rented out. They're all open. They have all kinds of stuff everywhere. As you guys can see, you know, they're selling stuff here and so on and so forth. But yeah, for whatever reason, look, that's a bank. Maybe you can rent mod. I think maybe you can rent. I can't even speak. You can rent motos here. I don't know if you can buy or rent or both. I gotta look into that. Look at that. Look at these bikes. Look at the prices on these bikes. So this is like about $1,000. These things go for like around $1,000 US, give or take. Maybe a little more. So around $1,100. Look at this one. This is like $2,000 for this Honda. Look at that. $2,000 for this dirt bike. Look at that shit. Awesome, right? So $20,000 is about $1,000, right? So that's $2,000, a little more than that. You can get a little idea. Look at this, even more over here. All right, I'm gonna run across. Fuck it, because I'm... Anyways, I'm hoping I'm going the right way, but we'll find out soon enough. Man, it is so hot and sweaty. You know, another thing too, like, when you're walking around and you see that you're not the only one that's hot and sweaty like I am right now, when you see locals, you know, tons of locals that are sweating just as bad as me. And in fact, in my case, my girlfriend weighs like what, 80, 90, 100 pounds, some shit like that. And she sweats just as much as I do. That's how hot and humid it is out here. That's how hot it is out here. And also, it also shows you that, you know, people live without air conditioning 24 hours a day and they survive. And most people out here have air conditioning of one form or another, but you know, it's all about, do you really need it 24 hours a day? You know, like I was literally talking to my aunt the other day, you know, because the whole hurricane that was about to hit Florida. And it's funny because the only thing that everyone was worried about back home in Miami was about the power going out and not having any electricity. And I'm like, fuck, bro, are you kidding me? That's like nothing here. You know what I mean? Like that's normal here. And it's funny because then I was listening to a comedian that he lives in Houston. And he's like an Indian, from Indian parents. And when the hurricane hit Houston a couple years ago, and he was calling his parents to check in, you know, his parents were like, oh my God, this hurricane thing is so awesome. It's perfect. It's just like monsoon season back home. And we're saving on electricity because the power went out. We got the windows open. You know, this is beautiful. It's an awesome thing. So it's again, how many people were like, oh my God, like the worst thing in the world is what was happening with the hurricane. So again, it's all about perspective, guys. It really is all about perspective. Look at these streets. And I'm like doing the whole touristy thing, like if I don't live here, huh? Also look here, they sell all kinds of stuff for, you know, this is like a hardware store, you know, where they sell all kinds of stuff. You know, everything from the cables to water things, you know, everything you want in like a hardware store. But again, there's like a specialty hardware store, you know, where they sell, well, you know, if you're in the business, you know what the fuck is in there. If you're not in the business, you don't need me to explain what was in that store. But you guys can figure it out. You know, things like fixtures and cables and, you know, pretty much all the nuts and bolts that you need in order to build. Because as you guys can see, you know, this is a perfect example of, you know what I mean? These places are turning into these places all over town. You know, and again, this is called gendermification. You know, this area isn't immune to gendermification. But as you guys can see, look at the, you know, and you see this everywhere. You see a lot of these buildings like this, okay? And you see a lot of buildings like that, and you're just seeing the transfer. And there's probably people living in there, and there's probably people living in there. You know what I mean? And you can just already figure it out. You know what I mean? Like the whole thing here. Look at that. That's like some kitchen, I think. Hey, sorry about that, guys. I think the camera overheated. I wasn't really quite sure. I wasn't looking at the camera while it was filming and turned off. I'm hoping I was able to capture stuff. But regardless, you know, I think I know when it cut off, so it's no big deal. Regardless, so I'm almost at my destination. And I'm going to see if I can just film a quick little ending, you know, as I get closer to there. And that's it. You know, it's funny because as I'm walking around, this is like a lot of people are say that this looks like Cuba, this feels like Cuba, and it kind of does. I've never been to Cuba. I'm going to be going to Cuba soon, and it's really interesting because it does have that feel, and it does have that energy of like being in Cuba. So like I myself can't wait to go to Cuba, and in a weird way I'm already kind of like primed for that, because that's how it is. I mean, again, it's obviously not Cuba. People aren't fucking starving, and it's like obviously a way worse situation over there, but it's you can easily see how this looks like Cuba in a way, you know, and feels like Cuba. But again, you know, some of you guys might understand exactly what I'm saying. Some of you guys have no idea what the fuck I'm saying. Man, it's really, you know, every time I come out to this exact spot, I'm always telling myself, all right, bro, make sure you write down the address. Make sure you get like a card. Make sure you get some sort of whatever so that you know where this place is next time you come back. And I always forget to do that. And I'm always like looking for it, and I'm always lost. And I think I see it up ahead, but you know, that happens all the time. It's like a mirage. I think it's over there. Look, that's a dentist. I think this building looks familiar, so. But I think it's that one over there next to that pink building. Because I'm going to get me my new glasses, you know? So, like, you already know I got glasses. I did an episode on glasses, but I got other pair of glasses that I'm going to see if I can do. So, look, this guy's like a delivery guy, and he's just parking the street. Oh, actually, he's a mail guy. So, that's pretty cool. Hola, buenos días. So that's how they deliver the mail out here, huh? Pretty interesting, huh? It's awesome. Okay, so that's not the place. Oh, it is the place. Look at that. Ta-da. That's the place. So, all right. Well, I'm going to do a quick little outro here. So, all right, guys. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed today's episode. I'm going to see how I edit this with all the music that was playing everywhere. We're already in the northern part of the city. It's a little quieter out here. as you guys can see. And, you know, I'm about to go and get my glasses. So I'm going to be in there maybe another half hour, you know, where I get new glasses retrofitted. And that's it. And then I'm going to do another episode when I get out of here. So, guys, just want to give a big shout out to all my patrons. Want to give a big shout out to every single one of you guys out there that's always contributing, whether you're sending, you know, Bitcoin, Digibyte, cash, you know, thumbs ups, watching my advertisements, spreading the knowledge. It doesn't matter. You guys are all very integral to everything I'm doing, and I love you guys, and you guys are the best. And I just want to say thank you, thank you, thank you. I fucking love you guys. And don't forget to please like, please subscribe, please hit that bell icon, and please stay awesome, and please enjoy the rest of your day. And thank you so much for watching. I'll see you guys laters, alligators. Peace. Hey guys, guess what? Me and Lambo are still here. We haven't left yet. You know why we're here? Because I want to tell you all about this new store that I just opened up. Yeah, that's right. It's our new sponsor as well. Let me tell you a little bit more about it. So, as you guys can see, this is the store. I just opened up the store, I don't know, about a week ago. And I'm going to be selling all my merch and all of our stuff here, whether it's Lambo stickers, whether it's, you know, mugs, t-shirts, jackets, you name it. We got all kinds of stuff that you guys can buy and help support the show. Now you get to have your very own shirt or your very own Lambo sticker. And if you guys want any special requests on things for me to put in the store, then please, by all means, let me know. And we'll get our graphic artist, you know, on top of it. Yeah, that means you gotta work, Lambo. All right, guys. Thank you so much. Love you guys, and I'll see you guys mañana.